Ah, so what's for dinner tonight? Oh, okay. Oh, that was intense. Welcome to my channel, I'm Tristan Duran, and this is my Café Racer subframe for my 1983 Yamaha Virago. On the last video, I painted the entire thing. I made some runs. I need to go over the entire subframe, see where I have the runs. I have my marker right here. I'm gonna circle where I have the runs, and then I'm gonna wet sand to make it perfect. Okay, so we are done. I have all my runs. It's quite a bit. And if I want to show you those blue circles that you can see right here, it is really hard for me to show the runs on the camera because I really need to play with the reflection of the light to be able to see those runs. And they are not huge runs. I really try to make that piece perfect. And I want to show the process as well on many, many different areas. So just one thing, you saw that I put that subframe in the oven. Why? Because the paint was not super hard. When I touched it, I was like, this is dry, but not really dry overnight. So what I did is I put 175 Fahrenheit for 2 hours, and that worked like a charm. That was amazing. Just remember, 175 degrees Fahrenheit for 2 hours. What I noticed is the two areas in contact with the cardboard in the oven, it was set like that, and yes, cardboard would not burn at 175 degrees Fahrenheit, way higher than that, so it's safe. Those two areas that touch the cardboard here, the paint is missing. It's like maybe it went too hot. I don't know what happened, but this, I remember for the next time when you put something in the oven, do not have the part touch. I'm going to show what I mean because obviously it's going to touch somewhere, but I think what you need to do is to rig something up where you put something maybe here in the hole, but not something here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to paint after I'm all done with the wet sanding. Now I'm going to use a razor blade like this right now, like the classic single side razor blade. And I'm going to go for the biggest runs. I'm gonna shave them a little bit, and then I'm gonna do the wet sanding. Done with the wet sanding. This is all finished. I just did 600 grit. Why? Usually I would have done 600, 1200 and move on like that to have a very smooth finish. But because I'm gonna paint again, I'm not just gonna buff it, but I'm gonna paint again. It's fine. 600 is good. I need to repaint because of those two areas that were touching in the oven right here. And so the paint is missing right over here. That's the only reason why I need to repaint. Otherwise I would have gone and do that wet sanding the whole way through. But 600 it is. When I look with the light on the reflection, I can tell my runs really disappeared. So one coat, just one coat of paint on this, and I'm done with the painting. What now? Oh, I know. This is the LED strip I'm gonna have in the back with my taillight, my stoplight, and my turn signals right here. I have no instructions. I have a bunch of very thin threads, wires, right here. And I don't know which is which, so I'm gonna test that. And when it's done, I'm gonna have to solder some. Let's try it. So I'm gonna have a bet here. I have five wires. I have a black, green, white, red, yellow. I'm gonna bet the black wire is the ground. So I'm gonna connect that to the motorbike battery right here. Now, I'm gonna try the four other wires to see what they are. And then I'm just gonna note which wire is which. So I've got the black is negative ground, the green is the right turn signal, the white is the taillight, the red is the stoplight, and the yellow is the left turn signal. How did I find the difference between the white and the red? The white is less bright than the red. White. And then I'm gonna try the red. Right here. That's the stoplight, that's the taillight. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna solder on those five wires the terminal, the bullet terminals that fit with my harness and my motorbike. And finished. The LED taillight is completely soldered. I did the five wires. I put some heat shrink tubing at the end, right here by the terminals, just to make it waterproof. Very happy with the result. I can't wait to put that on the bike. What I need to do right now, it's been almost 3 hours that the subframe has been in the oven. Let's check it. Regular kitchen oven, right here. Nothing fancy, not a painter's oven here. 175 degrees Fahrenheit for what was supposed to be 2 hours. It's been almost 3 hours. The subframe is set in a way that it's not touching the cardboard. That's why you see those red bases here, the cones, and then you see the yellow ones up there in the screw holes to keep that subframe in the air. Because previously when I wasn't doing that and the subframe was just on the cardboard, I saw that the areas touching the cardboard, the paint was melted. Not a good look. So let's take it out and inspect the result. I am super happy with the result. It is super smooth, super shiny. I am so blown away by my spray painting abilities right now. It's getting better. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it on the bike right now. Everything lines up really well. The subframe is very sturdy on the bike. I got the screws on the top, I got the screws at the bottom. It looks pretty good. I'm happy with it. The thing is, I'm realizing I need to clean up a lot of things out of the bike because I need some room. I need to reroute that harness. I need to remove that battery holder that's not gonna stay here. I need to remove the airbox on the other side just to make some more room. And I also have those tabs right here on the frame. And I need to take them off. Like, I don't need those anymore. I think they were for the original seat, maybe to grab on it. I will use the Dremel, remove those welds right here. The tabs are gonna go out. That means I'm gonna have to do some paint on the frame. So a lot of little things just to clear things up and get moving on that rear end. So that's gonna happen in the next video. If you wanna see more about that build, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification so you're notified when I post a new video. If you like the video, well, like the video. I see you in the next video, and meantime, keep fixing.